So, Kamera läuft.
Eins. Zwei.
Drei.
Vier.
Jawohl, sehr schön. Okay, andere Seite.
Ich kann gleich wieder darüber. Eins. Zwei.
Jawohl, sehr schön, cool, danke. Hervorragend. Okay, so today we had a look at Paulus Hector Mair's Poleaxe play No. 6, and as you know this, we go through it step by step again and try to explain what we thought about it. Lass mal den Wechsel bitte. Okay, we begin with the quad hall, or no, not a quad hall, I just go for his head. And all I do is going forward with one step, and I don't need to change the structure of my arms much because it's just coming down at his head if I go like this. Okay, and don't need to adjust much. So he doesn't want this and parries. And what I can do now, or let's leave it like what I do now is I overbind him and press him down, and it's for him it's much harder to bring his arm up than for me pushing down. So in this principle, I bring him here and go for his knee. And now usually I would make, so when I'm here at his. So when I'm here at his knee, I would usually make a step back. So I would step back and pull him. And at one point he will lose balance and land on his ass. So next step, bring him down. Oh, he doesn't allow this. And hooks into my neck and pushes me towards him, which prevents me making my step back. So I can get him. And if he makes a step back now, he has pretty good control over me and can pull me through the wall. Okay. I know that he's going for my neck, and I go up with my poleaxe, and in the same time doing a triangle step, going here and going wide above my head. I want his arms to be behind his head, so he's beginning to lose balance now. He's beginning to lose balance now, and this is the point where I release my left hand, take his knee, and now I can I can throw him if I want. I need some knobs here. Okay, so that's it for today. Danke.
Danke.
And thank you.